Hi there. TensorFlow is no longer what it used to be. So, let's have a quick history of development overview. TensorFlow 1 is one of the most widely used deep learning packages. That's largely due to its great versatility, which makes it the preferred choice of many practitioners. Unfortunately, it has one major drawback. It's very hard to learn and use. That's why many people are disheartened after seeing just a couple of lines of TensorFlow code. Not only is the method strange, but the whole logic of coding is unlike most libraries out there. This led to the development and popularization of higher-level packages, such as PyTorch and Keras. Keras is particularly interesting, as in 2017 it was integrated in the core TensorFlow, a feat that may sound a bit strange at first. In reality, though, both TensorFlow and Keras are open source, so it shouldn't be surprising that such things happen in the programming world. In fact, Keras' author claims that Keras is conceived as an interface for TensorFlow rather than a different library, making this integration even easier to digest and implement. So far, so good. Anyway, even with Keras as a part of TF, TensorFlow was still losing popularity. This was addressed in 2019, when TensorFlow 2.0 came on the horizon, or at least its alpha version. We can say that was TensorFlow's effort to catch up with the current demand for higher-level programming. Interestingly enough, instead of creating their own high-level syntax, the TF developers chose to borrow that of Keras. Actually, this decision made sense, as Keras was already widely adopted and people generally love it. On that note, you may hear people saying, TensorFlow 2 is basically Keras. And that isn't far from the truth. In fact, TF2 has the best of both worlds. Most of the versatility of TF1 and the high-level simplicity of Keras. Sounds great, right? And that's not all. There are also other major advantages of TF2 over TF1. Simplified API, no duplicate or deprecated functions, and some new features in the core TensorFlow. But what's important for us is that TensorFlow 2 boasts eager execution, or, in other words, allowing standard Python rules of physics to apply to it, rather than complex computational graphs you don't really want to work with.
If you found this video interesting and want to gain an edge in your career, make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. And don't forget to check out some of our other videos for another quick win in the data science skills department.